We are at Prairie Creek, which is on the Alabama River. I'll show you what our view looks like. This is the view that we have right now. That is the Alabama River right there. It's moving pretty swiftly right now. And down that way is the lock and dam, Jones Bluff lock and dam is down that way. So we may ride over there and look at that tomorrow. But we're in one of the Federal Corps of Engineer parks tonight, instead of actually out in the real woods somewhere. But this is a nice place. We've camped here before, but it's been several years ago. So we decided to come back tonight and spend the evening. And then tomorrow we'll do some exploring around the wildlife management property that's out this way. And so right now we're setting up camp. We got our hammocks up between these three trees, I guess you could say here. And we're gonna get the quilts out and put those on the hammocks, because it's gonna be a little cool tonight. It's supposed to get down into the lower 30s. We got our quilts up on our quilts up on the hammocks. I've got my Jack's Are Better Greylock 3. If you're a hammock guy, you might want to know that. But got the quilt in there. I've got a down top quilt down in there as well. And I've got my War Bonnet Blackbird hammock there. And Thomas has got the Skeeter Beater Pro from Grand Trunk for his hammock. And that's a quilt that I made, a climbing shield for his quilt. It's under quilt, and he'll just use a sleeping bag in there for top quilt tonight. His tarp's one that I made out of argon as a type of material, and that's what he'll be using tonight. It's gonna be a clear night, so we really don't know if we need a tarp, but just in case. And it will keep the wind off, because it might be a little breezy. And I've got my War Bonnet. It slipped in my mind. Big tarp from War Bonnet with the doors. Big Mama Jama, or whatever it is. But anyway, it's a big tarp with doors for me tonight. Right, so this is the creek side, Prairie Creek side. The river's up there on the other side where we got our tarps and hammocks set up. But this is the creek side of the campground. This is the campground itself is kind of like a little peninsula that sticks out, and the creek comes in on this side over here, and the river is over there on that side. So, but the guy, when we were checking in, the guy told me that they had these white pelicans, like a whole flock of them, that had come in, and they're snow white. And I don't know if you can see them on this camera, but there's three of them straight across there, and then there's a fourth one coming right up there. And typically around here, the pelicans you see down on the Gulf are gray in color, but these are really, really white, like snow white, like you'd see like a seagull or egret or something like that. So it's kind of interesting, but there's some right out there. He said we would see them, and we did. Prairie Creek has, you know, your typical campground with RV sites out this way. We came in from that way, but the tent only sites back here are you park right here where I'm parked, and this little point has about five or six campsites out here that are just for tents, and you have to walk to them. It's not very far, but this is kind of what it looks like. So if you're interested in coming out here to Prairie Creek and tent camp, this is a nice spot. Thomas and I are set up right in there. But there's a spot there, another one down that way, and then one there. And then as you make your way out this way, there are, I believe, two more, maybe three more spots out this way. There's one here, and all of them have a table and a grill and a fire pit. as well as they have electricity and water. I forgot about that, but they do have electricity and water. That's another spot there. And then one here. And then actually there is one more right out here on the far point. So this is a river here, over here on the left-hand side that you're looking at. The sun's setting over that way, nice and bright. And I'm probably thinking that some of this erosion here is probably from that flood that we had about a month or so ago. I'm sure this area was underwater. But on this side over there is the Prairie Creek. And the point, there's another site right here. Actually, I guess there's one here. Yeah, this is the last one, 58. There's another water and electricity right out here, but it's not technically not a campsite. So this is a little overlook right out here. And so what you're seeing there to the right is Prairie Creek back up in there and back around this way. And then over here to the left is the main river out that way. That's the Alabama River. We slept very well, nice and warm all night. There's the river this morning. So far, we woke up with a bald eagle right up there, which was extremely unusual for here. This is the what our morning looks like on the riverside. Creek's over there. And beautiful sunrise this morning. So we're gonna get us a little bit of breakfast going. But like I was saying, there was a bald eagle sitting right up there in that tree this morning, squawking. Big one too, beautiful. And around here in our part of the world, in Alabama, we don't see those very often. So that was kind of a treat to wake up and see that this morning. He sat there for a few seconds after I got up. Thomas watched him for a few minutes and then he flew off. So this morning we're having hawk victuals, breakfast grits, bacon and egg. I'm going to fix that up here in just a minute. That's what that looks like. I've used, or I had several hawk victuals, dried, freeze-dried, or dehydrated meals before. But we're also having leftover sausage from last night, too. So we'll get that going here in a little bit and let you know how it tastes. All right, so Thomas says that the hawk victuals, breakfast grits, bacon, and egg is about an 8 out of 10. Good. I think it's at least that, maybe a little more. It's actually good stuff, especially with that Kaneka sausage in there. And that's what it kind of looks like, at least what's left of mine. Thomas is digging into his pretty good, so I think he likes it. So if you're looking for a easy-to-fix breakfast, hawk victuals, breakfast grits, bacon, and egg. Coffee is served. Just in time for Thomas to get the fire going a little better. Okay, so now we're in the lounge wildlife management area. Thomas and I are going to do a little exploring. We are parked in the, I think it was called the Old Field Road parking lot right back there. And we're headed that way. There's a lot of planted, looks like hardwoods, all through here on this property. So we're just going to walk and explore some and just see what we can find. So this is a little cemetery or graveyard we found in here. A couple of little headstones. I can't really make them out. Somebody Ivy, it looks like. Garden Lisa. Artelisa Ivy, wife of Jesse Ivy. I can't make out the year, but. Okay, so this is a, this person died in 1844. I don't know if these are original or if people moved them here or what, but died August 1844. Can't tell the name on that one.
1828
here. So if these are original, then 165 years ago, this stuff was here. All right, we're taking a little bit of a break now. We've walked, about a mile so far. I think, let's see, 1.3. We walked 1.3 miles so far, and we're gonna have us a little bit of a sit down and snack, and we're gonna have a packet gourmet banana pudding with toasty cakes, vanilla bean custard, bananas, and toasted coconut. So Thomas and I are gonna split that for a snack. And while Mr. Boyd doctors his injury over there in backwoods fashion with duct tape and paper towels. And a couple of band-aids too, I think. So. Okay, Thomas and I agree. The banana pudding is good. You agree, Thomas?
Yeah.
Thomas is eating his little portion over there. Finishing up mine. Banana pudding is a good thing from Packet Gourmet. Okay, so we came up on this little pond here, or lake, or whatever you want to call it. We came from that way. After we had our little snack, we kept coming on down the road, and we came upon this. So we're gonna keep walking that way, I think, and see what we can find. Pretty neat looking place. It's got fish jumping in there. So we'll keep looking. The map didn't show something like this on there, so I'm not real sure what this is, but we'll keep going, see what we can find. All right, so we made it through that thick stuff right there. That's some kind of a little stream or creek that runs through there. And it was covered up in briars and brambles and low limbs and stuff, so kind of had to hack our way through there and cross a little stream. And now we're back on this side of that little creek, headed back in the direction of the truck, which should be in that general direction. So we had to take a bit of a detour as we came upon that out there, which is just a swamp. All throughout there is a swamp, so we hit that back that way and decided to come skirt along that back towards the road. So the road's right up here. Hopefully we won't have to cross any creeks to get to it, and then we can walk along the road right back up that way to the truck. So we made it back out to the road, and we're making our way back to our vehicle, and then we're gonna probably eat some lunch, because I'm sure Mr. Boyd is hungry, and I'm pretty hungry too. We've walked about 2.5 miles so far today, so had a good little walk in the woods. So we'll go back to the truck and then see what we can find for lunch. This is the area that we were going to camp at. This is the primitive camping area here at the close to the Holy Ground Park. That it's the only primitive area, or only camping area, only place they let you camp here in the wildlife management area here. And so, but we chose to go up to Prairie Creek, even though this would have been free. Just not much of a view of the river from here at all, really. And it's kind of trashy. I mean, people, I don't know, people just make a mess. There's trash over there. There's an old chair. There's another old chair down this way I saw in the woods. You can see, you know, people leave trash. There's broken bottles, Vienna sausage can, old tin cans. People are messy. So we're gonna pick, sit down here for a little bit, fix us up some lunch. We got another Hawk Vittles meal, Southwest lasagna, and a Mountain House chicken salad. I don't have the wraps for wraps, but I don't have the wraps with me, so we're just gonna eat the chicken salad. I've had the chicken salad before, it's really good. It's easy to fix. You just do it with cold water. Okay, Southwest lasagna from Hawk Vittles. It's got ground beef, salsa, spaghetti sauce, ricotta cheese and Parmesan cheese, and pasta. And this is a single serving. So, it says to cover it with boiling water just above the food and let it stand for 15 minutes. So this is what I'm gonna do. I got it in my little zebra pot here, and I'm gonna cook it on this little setup here. This is an Emberlet fire ant stove. It's a little wood burning stove that also works as a stand for the Trangia alcohol stove, which is one of my favorite little stoves. It's not the lightest, but it works, and it's pretty sturdy, so I never had any trouble with it, so I like it. And this little fire ant stove from Emberlet is designed to hold the Trangia, and it also comes with a little flat piece to go in there if you want to burn Esbit tablets too, if you want to. I don't do that very often, but it's capable of doing that. So Hawk Vittles, Southwest lasagna, yummy, good stuff. So we might come back out here sometime. This is what we walked, did a little walking around, and looks like there's a good bit of trash people leave behind. So I don't know what kind of people come out here and camp, and whether or not we run into a crowd of people that we prefer not to be around. But might not be too bad. But this area would be really good for right in here for hanging your hammocks if you hammock camp. These trees are almost surely can find plenty of trees spaced out just right to hang your hammocks on. And then if you tent camp, obviously you got plenty of open space here to put your tent. So it would work for either one, tents or hammocks. So we might come back and give it a try, and maybe come out and spend the night, and then go do some more exploring over on the wildlife management land.